Hello everyone, I am Cheshta and I welcome you all to the NABARD Grade A 5-day question series. And in this video, I am going to discuss about the agriculture census. Now I'll be discussing more about the 2010-11 census and the 2015-16 census. I'll tell you in this video why I am going to discuss both the census and why they are important for the examination. Now let's begin with the first question. Also, there's a question at the end of the video, so do watch the video till end and answer that question in the comment section. So the first question is, the first agriculture census was conducted in which year? We know that the Agri Ministry, that is the Agriculture Ministry, conducts this agriculture census and it is being conducted in 5 years. So it's conducted every 5 years, and since 1970, this agriculture census is being conducted. Now comes the question that why I am going to discuss the 2010 census, 2010 and 11 census and the 2015-16 census. Now what happens, this agriculture census is conducted in 3 phases. See, so there are 3 phases of census, the phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3 of the census. For 2010 and 11, the whole census has been conducted. That means the phase 1, 2 and 3, these 3 phases have been completed and a compiled report has been released. But for 2015-16, only the phase 1 has been released. So the phase 1 has been released recently. So it becomes important that we know about the recent finding of this phase 1, 2015-16 census. Now, if the phase 2 and 3 of the census have not been released for 2015 and 16, therefore it's important to consider the phase 2 and 3 of 2010-11 census. So this is how I am going to explain you about the findings, the important findings of the agriculture census of both these years. Now coming to the phase 1, 2 and 3. So phase 1 is basically the overview where the operational holdings in the countries are enumerated along with the so suppose the block, the tehsil, the district and state, the these have been divided and they are calculated, or the land holdings are calculated according to the classes, the social groups, SC, ST and the types of holding. So if they are holding, if their holding is according to the individual partners, the joint partners and even the gender, male, female. So this is how, or this is what the phase 1 includes. The phase 2 is conducted only on the 20% of the villages in the each tehsil. So it calculates or it takes into consideration the field work, basically the tenancy particulars, the cropping pattern, the dispersal of the holdings, the irrigation status of the states or the villages. So this is how they calculate the phase 2 of the agriculture census. Coming to the third phase, so third phase or the final survey is more popularly known as the input survey. So the input survey is something which is the compiled report of the agriculture census and more popularly known as the phase 3 survey. So in this input survey, we compile the whole data along with the 7% of the villages which we have surveyed in 2000 in phase 2. So this is how they have divided the 3 phases of the agriculture census, and it's important to learn about that. Now this 2015-16 census is the 10th census, remember this thing, and 2010-11 was the 9th census, and the first census was conducted in 1970. Moving on to the next question, so in how many classes the operational holdings of the land have been classified as per the phase 1 of the agriculture census 2015-16? So let me just tell you that 2015-16 and 2010-11, the classes of the land holdings have not been changed. So there are 5 classes of the land holdings. Can you name them in the comment section? Which are the 5 classes in which the operational land holdings have been divided according to this census? Let's discuss each one of these. So the first one is marginal. Next one is small. The third is the semi-medium. So it's semi-medium. The fourth one is medium and fifth one is large. It's important to remember the classes of the operational holdings. It was same for 2010-11 and for the 2015-16 census also. So the size class for marginal is below 1 hectare. For the small operational holdings, it ranges from 1 to 2 hectares. So semi-medium, it is from 2 hectares to 4 hectares. Medium, it is 4 hectares to 10 hectares, and for large, it is 10 hectares and up. So this is how they have classified the operational holdings of the land as per the, or it is being calculated in the phase 1 of the agriculture census, both for 2010-11 and 2015-16. The next question is, as of agriculture census 2015-16 phase 1, the operational holdings stand at, so what is the amount or what is the unit of the operational holding, the total unit for India? So in 2010-11, the operational land holdings was 138 million hectares. Now it has grown to 146 million hectares. It's a factual information, nothing much to discuss in this question, but it's very important to remember this information for this agriculture census 2015-16, and it can be asked in the examination. Now we talk about in terms of states, so which state has the largest number of operational holdings or largest number of farmers? So Uttar Pradesh has topped the 2015-16 census, where there are 23.82 million of farmers. So it's important to remember this number as well and the name of the state as well. So a question might come in the examination regarding which state has topped the agriculture census 2015-16 as per the operational holding. So it's Uttar Pradesh and it is followed by Bihar. Now moving to the next question. So in terms of the operated area, which of the following state has made the highest contribution? Now, before going to the answer of this question, it's important to know what is the operated area, what is considered as the operated area. So, it includes both the cultivated and the uncultivated land, provided that part of it is put to the agriculture production during the period. So, this is what we consider as the operated area. Now, in terms of the operated area and as per the census 2015-16, Rajasthan has topped the state, or it has made the highest contribution in terms of the operated area with 20.87 million hectares, which is followed by Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh. So you might think that the information is quite factual in nature, but these information are recent and can be asked in the examination, as it's the recent agriculture census and the news came in February 2019. So there was this PIB which was released and the summary of the same was given in that PIB. The next and very important question, so which of the following was the most dominant crop in case of the gross unirrigated area as per the survey 2011-12. Now, input survey 2011-12, this means that the agri census 2010-11. So this was released in 2011, but the agriculture census, it takes into consideration the 2010-11 survey. And as it is more popularly known as input survey, therefore I have mentioned input survey 2011-12. So we cannot take all the crops. So what the census has done is that the nine major crops have been taken and rest of the crops have been divided as under the head other crops. So total of all crops, so nine crops plus other crops makes up to all crops. The name of these nine crops are paddy, bajra, maize, jowar, wheat, tur or harad, sugarcane, groundnut and cotton. So these are the names of the nine major crops, and the other crops, rest of the crops have been classified as other crops. So the question is asking about the most dominant crops in case of the gross unirrigated area. Now there are two kinds of area, the gross unirrigated area and irrigated area. So in terms of both gross unirrigated and irrigated area, paddy was at the first position, but the percentage was quite different. So in terms of unirrigated area, the paddy accounted for 18.9% of the share, and in terms of the irrigated area, it accounted for 33.5%. It's very important to remember that paddy was among the most dominant crop among these nine crops. Also, try to remember the name of these nine crops which have been classified or being considered as the most important crops in India. Also, you can find the PDF of this document in the description box. You can just click on the description box. You can just click on the link and download the PDF from for the information related to the agriculture census, and it's very important to study that for examination. Now it's time for you to comment. Who is the current agriculture minister of India? So mention your answer in the comment section below. Who is the current agriculture minister of India? And do not forget to download the PDF from the description box. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Anuj Jindal and press the bell icon as well, as it will help you in receiving the notification as and when the video is being posted. Thank you so much for watching the video.